Oh, welcome back to our channel, Fishing the Trossachs. We're out here in the Lake of Menteith again, on the quest for a monster. I've decided I'm going to start a quest for the monster. We're after a big pike, a big mama pike. And I've totally lucked out here, guys, because I bumped into Rob. We're both setting up at the same time. He started chatting, invited me out in his boat. So he's giving me some tips, some pointers, let me use a couple of flies. And yeah, totally locked out. So my boat's still at the thing, and we're on Rob's boat. We've not caught nothing yet, but it will happen. I'm sure of it. My hat's a wee bit messed up, as you can see, but I definitely need it. So yeah, we'll just take some clips of the fishing. Fingers crossed we catch. We've had no fish just yet. We've had one follow all morning. It's 1:45. Nothing yet, but the wind's picking up, so that's a good sign. Fingers crossed we'll go into them soon.
These flies are so hard to cast compared to trout flies. So Rob says it's all about moving the water, fast paced. Sink a minute. Just twist it around a wee bit. There we go. And if you catch when you do this, you've got to hand strike it. So that'll be interesting. These fish is quite... Six casts can hang, move on. There's no catching. tip of the flies, amazing movement. I think I'm going to go over here. There's a nice big tree, a new bank there. Go to the pipe there. Getting so burnt. That's crazy. Getting better at my cast, that's for sure. So it's only a couple of foot here. Deep, I've just seen a wee trout take it. There's definitely a fish here. There should be pike here. So far we've had two follows. One on Rob's rod and one on mine. But no pikes. Actually, I had a trout follow as well, so three if you count the trout. It's of course me being a rubbish fisherman, I would have needed a trout. Drift now, I might get over to the good bits. The wee wind picked up. Cast. Tell you, hearing these flies whiz by your head is something else. I'd imagine it would hurt if they sunk into you. Bite man, fly. Yes, that's it, man. There's no such thing as one more cast, is there? But this will have to be the last cast. Because I've got to end up in the bike otherwise. And this wind. Just come around the corner, I've just seen Rob, he's just lost one, cutting. I've come around the corner, he's been on and he's lost it. Here, and hopefully we'll just drift down into that bit there, and a bit along. The osprey's just flying above the wee island just there. Quickly. This is where I was fishing the other night in my last video. Just this area. But I had no luck, obviously. Hopefully, I'll have some luck today. Problem with that fast trip, I always go too much. I'm pretty hungry, I tell you. Oh, I just seen a flash there too. That was a follow. I don't want to leave any rubbish on the boat. That's pretty much been nesting on that island. Oops. I just hit the camera. I'm surprised how well my back's held up actually, this trip. I'm not in that much pain. A lot of dragonflies mating just now. get throwing it. Rob was casting into these weeds, these weedless flies, and it's just unreal precision. Like, there's wee pockets where he thought there was a pike. He was getting it right in, it was incredible. It's a trout just jumped there. It's a real talent that I don't have. Not yet. So burnt. Oh, I'm gonna be sore tomorrow. I booked this last week and it was meant to be raining. That's why I booked it, because I was like, oh, it's cloudy, raining, good day for fishing. It's not even rained yet. And it's not windy either. One day I'll be good. That's what this channel is all about, because everybody you see on YouTube is, they're all professionals. They're all great. You never see anybody new just trying their absolute best. I go to the right venues. I'm fishing the right spots, using the right techniques. Then, like, lack of experience like that, you know, where you get the follow. I should have probably done a figure eight rather than just lifting my rod. There we go, we're getting into the weeds now. This will be my last cast. Right. Oh, I hope you've seen that, I was ready to vote. You'd have seen my face, I pooped myself. interesting. I could tell you what it is with this watch, but now that's obviously why people fly fish for pike. That was crazy. Top water take. That was probably a decent pike. Had plenty of length on it, big fat back. Damn. I need to angle this camera a bit better. Hopefully you can see that and me. You can't see me anymore. You see me? You can see me. I'll stand here. Damn, that was crazy. And I was hand stripping, so it's hard to actually hook up on it. So the fish they're eating, they're going to eat the top fish, the top water, and it happens fast. I need to know if I'm just going to eat it. There's a pike right there. Here we go. Let's catch a pike. Oh, I hope I got that on camera. That probably would have been a PB. For me, anyway. The pike for here are short and fat. Alright, I need to go into a different drift. Oh, I missed one, damn it. Can't believe it. Every dog has his day, and I'm sure my day will come soon. One day.
Still a chance.
If you're out in the water, there's always a chance. In fact, there was two fish behind your fly there. There was two fish behind your fly there.
I'm chasing it.
Aye, like at the start when you first put it out.
Yeah.
That's so cool. But here's meant to be good. So we'll get the rod out. I've been casting here for a while in this bay here where I had that bite earlier. And I've literally been staying here. The water's dead still. It's nice, but we need a wee bit of ripple, a wee bit of movement, a wee bit of wind to kick it up a bit and get the fish going. I've had one take, but I missed it, unfortunately. Lack of experience. A few follows, which is nice to see that there's definitely fish in there. Well, we know there's fish here. And Rob said none either. He said no fish in the boat either. And it's a few follows, but nothing else. I've been the closest just yet. But we've still got plenty of time. I'm sure we will get some fish on the boat today. The quest for a monster is still on. That was a big pike. Jesus. There's a pike just took right in front of, in between me and Rob. You see the swirl? She was a big one. It'd be nice if I could catch her. 7 o'clock. We've been fishing like 10 hours. Rob's had one on the line, but he spat it. He's turned a couple. I've had one take, but I, you know, lack experience. Never hooked it up. I've had a couple follows, but all the follows have been weir fish. Well, I just inspected. And the flies we're using are pretty big, so you're hoping not to get wee fish on it. So we're fishing this last drift. The wind's blowing down towards the boathouse. And it should take us past the boys, and we're fishing about 4 feet of water now, so it's a good talk. Weed beds, fingers crossed we'll get a pike on. But yeah, it's been a good day. I'm very, very burnt. If you go back to the start and see the state of my arms compared to the state of them now, I'm very, very burnt. I'm going to be sore tomorrow. Quest for a monster. Class of monster is 20 plus pounds. So we'll know it when we get it on. Looks like it's still ongoing. Here's the osprey coming. Right above us. Alright, we'll get a 20 pounder one day. Catch up on film. But that's it. Episode 1, Quest for a Monster. Lake Monteith. On the fly. That would be epic. I'm not set on the fly. It's pretty good though. It's really enjoyable. It's really active. You know, you're dead baiting. You're sitting there, your rod's out, chilling. For living a drink with your pals. You can't do that here. You're in the water. 10 hours I've been fishing now. So it's very, very active. Oh. Rob's on. On the camera, we'll get a wee zoom in. Rob's on. Happy days.
Hey, caught the jump. Oh, it's a nice size. Excuse the sugar shakiness, we're on the boat. I chose this spot. I came here. He followed me. That's my pike. I'm joking. Well done, Rob, if you're watching this. Hey! It's not that big. But it's still a pike, well done. Well done!
Never give up.
You should point it in my direction!
Rob shouted the cross. You never give up. And Rob has not stopped fishing all day. No jokes, he is generally not stopped.
I stopped for lunch. He never. I don't think he's had a bite the other day. Means the fish are on. Fish are biting. I'll go over there.
Catch a fish. Rob's saying he's wanting to come out in the float tube. Loch Acre, Loch Fenica, see what all is listed. Locks to do, and I said me too. So hopefully we'll get out together on that, from the fly rods. Again after the Pike. Looks like he's just had a fall. I'll change my fly. Fishing a black and silver with a blue flash. I thought that might be good. A lot of the bait fish here are silver, and but I think we'll go to one of Rob's flies, because he's just caught. So let's use this one. Black, gold, green, orange, a little bit of pink in it. Closer to the weeds. Yep, that's good. Are you getting a few follows, like? Are you getting more follows?
Yeah. Fish about the same
size, I think. Yeah, nice. There's ospreys.